Hello, this is Lucy speaking. Today at ANJ Education, we're going to be talking about biological sciences undergraduate degrees. So 15, 16, maybe 17, and really enjoy biology and think that you'd really like to study biology at university. Biology and the biological sciences in general are very, very common university degrees, highly regarded, but there are lots of options available to you. Many universities offer a straight biology course, but you'll also find that they offer more niche options. So you might be able to study an undergraduate degree just in microbiology or zoology or ecology. So you want to start thinking about, do you want a course that is broader and allows you to study various things and narrow it down in your 3 or 4 years of studying? Or do you already have a really clear idea of which area of biology you want to pursue? That's one important thing to think about. The other is, especially if you're going to be narrowing it down, is always to think about where you're trying to get after university. A general biology degree can be really, really useful. It teaches you lots of important skills, analysis, you're using maths and you're having a very strong quantitative skills, but biology is a science that involves more qualitative skills as well, so there'll be essays and things like that. So it's a very good degree that can get you lots of places. You can, I suppose, carry on into the sciences. There are also, because there are lots of biology, health, medical, tech and startups coming out now, there's a large need for people who have a background in the biological sciences because of this. So you might, for instance, be able to take your biology degree and go into venture capitalism because you actually know what these companies are talking about. Or again, similar for there are lots of biology and health tech company consultancies that you could work in. Or of course, you could teach, or you can become a scientist, do research, you can work in a lab, lots of options. But I would say if you're going in the more niche route, really, really check into where that degree can get you, because some areas such as conservation, whilst really, really important, like the very, very niche areas that you can go into. So always look out for where you're going to get with this degree. The other thing to think about is always, how do you go about applying? Always it's through UCAS. You'll probably, though it's not always actually required, need to do biology as an A level or a high level subject, and then other sciences are also useful. I would say maths and chemistry are the most useful other sciences, and sometimes if you want to, you can even take a humanities or a modern foreign language as well. But biology and chemistry will be a really strong foundation for studying the biological sciences at university. Sometimes an interview is required with biology, but not so much as with the other sciences. That will really vary on the course and the university, but it's something you should be aware of. And again, you don't really have to do anything extra unless you're applying to Oxford or Cambridge, and there shouldn't be any sort of entrance exams or anything like that involved. You do obviously want to work on your personal statement, so it's a good idea to read things like The New Scientist, keep up to date on what sort of news is happening in the scientific world and what advancements are being made. Other things for you to do is, like, are there any sorts of work experience you can undertake? There's biology isn't just like dissecting a frog. there are so, so many ways you can go about exploring that. And what you should really do is look into how you can show off in this personal statement that you're really passionate about this subject. And like what particular bit of biology at the moment is fascinating you. Because there are so, so many aspects. Like maybe you really, really like marine biology and this is what fascinates you, or you really, really like ecology. Like, explore your interests, because you'll need to talk about them in your personal statement. I would say that's probably the main thing we need to talk about today. So think about, firstly, whether you want to do a straight biology course or you want to pick one of the more niche options, because there are lots of options available to you. Also think about, you don't have to know for certain where you're, what sort of career you want to have, but I would say, particularly if you're picking zoology or something, have a look into it, because I know from my own friends that have gone down that route, it's a very small sector that has a lot of voluntary and unpaid positions, so it's worth really knowing what you're getting into. The other thing, obviously, make sure you're doing the right subjects at A level. Biology and other sciences are always good. Maths and chemistry in particular, always very strong options, and some universities will require them. But again, until you know the exact courses, you can't be certain. And then yeah, explore your interests. Tell them what exactly about biology makes you so excited. I never really liked the subject, so I can't tell you much, but obviously you do because you're considering it at A level. So tell the person who's going to be reading your personal statement what exactly fascinates you about it, and make sure that you have actual things to tell them and examples, such as an article in the New Scientist or some project you did. Like, give them actual examples rather than "I just really love it," and that's what they want to see. I think that's it for now. If you do have any questions, as always, please leave them below in the comment section. Hope you enjoyed our videos. You can click here for more, and you can click right here to subscribe.